I'm super excited that you decided to watch the show today. You know I'm all about living life unlimited, right? And one of the amazing things that we all do is watch a film, a movie, something, right, to take us on an amazing journey. Well, that's exactly what my guest is going to be doing. They're going to take us on their journey about the movie that they have just produced, an amazing film. So I want to tell you a little bit more about it, but I want you to stay tuned. So just watch these amazing messages, and we'll be right back.
And I'll be your professor today. And I will be talking about the brain.
Hello, I'm your veterinarian today.
You're kidding.
Nope, I'm Dr. Brooklyn. See?
Okay, doctor.
Oh, here, let me see.
Good morning, everyone. I'm your new coach. My name is Maddie. Nice to meet you.
I had the most fantastic day in the office. You'll never believe what happened. We got that new business I wanted.
You ever seen him fly?
Have you seen him what?
Fly?
No.
My cat can fly.
Okay.
The dog's brain can't think as much as the human's brain because there's no high school for the dog. This is Peter, the Triceratops. Peter is 1 year old. The T-Rex, Sally, is 1,252 years old. Knees up like a unicorn. Higher, higher.
I've been to New York, Transylvania, Pennsylvania. We can think and do lots of stuff with our brain. Now,
does anybody know how big the brain is?
Anybody?
Sophia. It is medium. Medium. Very good.
Hello, everyone, and welcome back. I am here with the producer of this amazing film, feature film, right?
Short film.
Short film.
Yes.
Okay, and her name is Hector Lynn German. Did I say it right, girl?
German.
Sorry. It's that southern dialect, you know, have it going on.
I got you.
You know, so I know you're this amazing producer, and you brought with you some of the cast members and also producer as well, right?
Yes. I'm her partner.
Your yeah. partner.
Producing partner.
So tell us your name so they can know who you are.
Danae. My name is Danae Jones.
Say it again.
Danae Jones.
Danae.
Yeah.
Girl, that sounds like a fancy perfume or something.
Sure.
And what's your name?
Hi, my name is Raquel Davies.
Oh, you're the star of the show.
Star.
She's the star. Yeah. So tell us a little bit about the writing, first of all, because that's pretty much where it starts from, an idea. So tell us a little bit about the history of your writing of this particular film.
So for Fiorella, I started off with the idea that everyone has choices in life. And for a lot of our youth, they don't always know that they have a choice in a particular situation. So that's where it started. What if someone knew that there was something else out there for them, that they didn't necessarily have to make the wrong decision in a particular moment? So that was the inspiration for the story, and that's how we got Fiorella.
Amazing, because a lot of youth people, you know, youth, period, they do struggle with things that because we all struggle when we was younger, you know,
yeah.
And then being able to have someone to kind of talk to about it and stuff like that. So how are you guys partner? How did that work out? You know, having this co-producer working with you, how you guys worked that out with the film?
We actually, we've met on sets. And then we have been friends for a long time since we met, and we've gotten along, and we both share a passion for wanting to tell stories that like make an impact. So we decided to partner together on this, and she has her own set of skills, and I have my own set of skills, and we kind of work those together. I mean, there's things that she is absolutely amazing at that I am just not good at.
You know, that actually makes a good pair, though.
Yeah,
I think we made each other stronger.
Yeah.
Because the strength and the weakness kind of equal out and make, and that's how you would make this amazing film.
Yeah, and it's so important to partner too, because there's only so much you can do as a person. You have your strengths, you know, but you need a team. That's how you make this.
Literally.
So when I looked at her and I was like, she has these strengths that I wish I had, but I don't have.
Yeah.
So I need that, and then I have a lot of strengths that, you know, that she doesn't have as well.
That's cool.
Yeah.
That's
as cool. I mean, as producers on set, you're kind of expected to do everything.
Mm-hmm.
And
Jack
thankfully, when I started working with Danae, I could enjoy being on set more because I wasn't so kind of bogged down with a million things that are going on. You know, I could enjoy the experience and, you know, get to talk to actors more rather than running around like ordering food and doing paperwork, which are things that she loves to
do. I'm very behind the scenes coordinating, which is my experience, like coordinating. So yeah, that's what I like to do.
Well, one of the things you just mentioned was acting, you know, and of course we have the star of the film here. Mm-hmm. So how important is it, you know, choosing the right person, you know, in order to play that particular part that she played?
Ooh, well, for this particular film, it's about a Liberian teen. So for me, it was really important to get a Liberian actress. We had gone through many rounds of auditions, kind of looking for someone who could be true to the dialect, because I didn't want people who were Liberian to watch the film and be like, that doesn't really sound quite right. And I wanted to honor the Liberian people. So, you know, when Raquel came in, not only was she an amazing actress, she could speak the dialect. She's Liberian.
Yeah.
Wow. So how did you feel actually doing a film that's, because you are you from Liberia, right?
Yeah, I'm from Liberia.
So how did it feel to be able to play the part of who you really are?
It felt like a rarity because our stories never get told. Maybe recently a play, you know, went around, it was national, but besides that, no one ever hears about Liberia. So when I booked the gig, I was elated. And it's such a small country, like, it just so happened that my mom even knows her father. Like, that proves it. In passing, we found that out.
Wow.
Yeah, we're from the same town in, you're from Gaithersburg?
Yeah, German.
Yeah, and I'm from Germantown, which is in Maryland.
Wow.
Yeah, mm-hmm. Like kind of one city over.
So how long have you guys been here in America?
Oh, well, all of our lives, we lived in the same town and like didn't even know each other, each other in Los Angeles.
Wow. Yep. Same town here.
No, in Maryland.
In Maryland.
Yeah. And our parents knew each other in Liberia.
Oh, so y'all are taking me on a journey already.
No, we figured this all out in casting. After we cast her, and she was practically in tears because she's like, that's the accent. So we started talking to her, and she's like, you're like, where are you from? And she's like, Maryland. We're like, okay, well, where in Maryland? Germantown? We're like,
whoa.
Well, Germantown. Yeah. And then I was like, oh, well, I knew this person, I knew that person, and they were just like having a good old time. I was like, this is good. We have a report now.
Casting ships a little bit.
Yeah.
Because, you know, right here in LA, you run into all different types of people from different places, but to be able to find someone exactly what you wanted for your film, I know that was like elating to know that that was possible.
Yeah. I felt like it was a sign from God because literally I had, right before coming into the audition with Raquel, I had called my mom and we had seen a lot of actresses at that point, and you know, they were trying, they were faking the accent the best they could, but you know, I was like, you know what, there's no Liberian actresses out here, mom, you know, I'm gonna have to just do the best I can. And then she walked in.
It was a great moment. She was our star.
Well, you are a star.
Thank you.
And the amazing thing about her, you know, I'm all about living life unlimited.
Yeah.
And the fact that she's living unlimited as well as you, because not only are you a star here, you'll be a star in your country.
I hope so.
You know what I'm saying? To be able to play, you're here making the film, but you're able to take that film back to, like you said earlier, that Liberians can see that it's one of us.
Absolutely.
You know, actually on TV, making it happen, doing what we need to do, and then you being a part of it. Because I'm telling you, it's good to have somebody to have those coordinating skills, girl, because
they're very good skills to have.
Girl, I'd be like, That's great. So one of the things, too, I saw you had other actors as well were they Liberian as well?
No, well, the film only called for the mom and the daughter, Fiorella, to be Liberian, and everyone else, you know, it was an American cast.
Awesome.
Yeah.
So how important is it, we're going to go to a break in a minute, but how important is it for your film to be in festivals and places like that so you can get the word out about it?
Well, it's incredibly important. I think the film has a powerful message that kind of the message of how important a parent serves in their child's life. And if not a parent, then an older figure looking out, as well as the importance of prayer. Like for me, my mom was always praying over me, and I feel like that's why I'm here today, and you know, the kind of the success story that I am, because you know, she always had my back and praying for me. So that's the message of this film, just how important it is to have a community behind you.
Well, you know, in the Bible, it talks about how it takes a village to raise a child.
Yes.
You know, and a lot of times, especially nowadays, people don't want no one else to have a say-so in their child. But when you have a group of people helping rear them, they do turn out a whole lot better.
Yeah.
Look at you, girl. You turn out a whole lot better.
Thank you, Melody.
You know, and you too. I mean, I just think it's amazing how you all work together. And when we come back, we want to talk a little bit about, like, how it was on set and being able to were you able to talk in the language as well? Did you talk in the
It's more so an accent as opposed to,
Let me hear how it sound, girl.
What do you want me to say?
Yeah! What you want me to say?
Oh, Lord, Jesus. Wow, you talk English, but it was just talking.
It's Liberian English. It's English with an accent. So it's,
so like if you say, how you doing, it'll say, how do. Like, you're like, how you, like, so it's like broken.
Yeah.
Wow, so it's almost like, you know, a Southern people, we cut off our words.
Absolutely.
Yeah, like a twang.
Like a twang.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
But girl, I love how that sounds. Wow, like, how you doing now? Oh my God. Well, you know what? We're just going to keep going in a little bit. But, you know, tell us the name of the film and where people can actually watch the film right now. I know you have the trailer going right now.
The trailer is going right now. The name of the film is Fiorella, and hopefully coming to a film festival near you. But a lot of the film, like I said, is geared towards the youth. So we're going to be hopefully getting it into schools so that, you know, the age group that it's targeting can be able to see it.
So they can see they got some help.
Yeah.
So, y'all, you stay tuned, because after these messages, we're going to be right back with some more with my amazing panel of people. And we want to talk some more in Liberian, because I'm going to be able to say one of them words.
Yes.
Not how you doing, but you're going to say something. Oh, my God.
Get the thing y'all want to show up.
Oh, we wouldn't miss it.
Let's toast. Let's toast to a super fun night.
Yeah.
And where do you think you're going dressed like one boy? Jesus.
Hello, everyone, and welcome back. I am super excited because I have the producer, co-producer, actress of Fiorella, right?
Fiorella.
Fiorella.
See, I'm rolls off your tongue.
Fiorella.
Fiorella.
See, that's why you gotta say that Liberian way. Say it Liberian way.
Fiorella.
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 Oh, sound like a jam, girl. I love that.
Thank you.
And one of the amazing things we was talking about earlier was why you chose to be a producer, you know, as well as you being a co-producer. Mm-hmm. Tell us a little bit why you chose that particular, you know, industry.
Well, in college, I studied accounting and theater production, knowing that I wanted to be on the business side of film, film and television production. So as a producer, I get to use both of those skill sets. It's actually like the perfect marriage, because I have to do business aspect things all the time. So,
businesswoman.
Yes. Businesswoman for sure.
That's cool.
So that's why I chose the profession.
That's amazing, though. That means, you know, businesswomen, you're going to always be successful, girl.
Thank you.
You know what I'm saying? Make money, throw some money over here, you know.
Exactly.
Super, super important.
Super important. Yeah. So tell us a little bit about why you chose, you know, the industry that you are doing, producing, as well as coordinating. I know you said that earlier.
Yes. So I was a coordinator when I met Hector Lynn on set. And when she suggested we work together as a producer, I was kind of like, okay, we'll see. So I started doing it, and I absolutely loved it. Yeah, and I get to use my coordinating skills when I do it, and I get to do more with that. And I just love, like, the other aspects of it as well, you know. Like, I love the puzzle pieces of putting this set together, you know. And I get to be involved. Like, as a coordinator, I can only do more, like, on-set sort of things. But now I get to put the project together beforehand and even after. Mm-hmm. You know, I get to have my hands in everything.
You're the creative control part.
Yes, exactly. I think I get to be more creative, yeah. And I think that's what I really like about it.
And
yeah.
Then you're able to live unlimited when you like that, because then, you know, because if you have part of the creative control, you can say, oh, you know, I think this will go good with that.
Yeah.
You know, even in choosing the actors as well. Mm-hmm. And then you can make a suggestion even with the script. Am I correct?
Oh, yeah. She was very, the first person I showed this script to other than my husband was Danae.
Yes.
Yes. Who gave a lot of feedback on it and kind of made it what it is. So, yeah, for sure.
That's amazing. Girl, you got power.
Exactly. And that's what I like, you know. And if it wasn't for her, I never would have experienced this.
You know, I think it's amazing, though, when you help other people get an opportunity, because I'm always about helping other people get to the next level.
Oh, yeah.
And, you know, and you being able to open that up for them as well as actress, as well as giving someone else the power to be, have that creative control. Because a lot of people want to be the one, the big dog in charge, you know, and so I commend you for just sharing that power with her, you know?
Yeah.
You know?
I'm definitely of the mindset that we all rise up together and to reach back and pull someone with you. So, like I said, Danae said, we had been friends for a couple of years, and I saw she had such a great work ethic, and so when I was kind of branching out doing films on my own, I said, hey, let's not just be friends, let's also be partners.
Yeah.
And that the fruits of that is Fiorella, and I am so proud of this film. So
what did you think when you first read it for the first time? When you read that script and you was like, I'm Liberian, I can do this.
I definitely felt like it was made for me. I felt like this was me at a certain period in my life. I felt that God had his favor on this whole project, you know, just the way that the pieces fell together. And I was just excited to tell this story because it's a really important story for the youth to hear. People, when you watch it at film festivals, you'll understand how powerful it is.
That's amazing. Mm-hmm. Because you know what, when you have a powerful message, especially if it's something that actually hits home for you, then other people can really relate to it, you know? Mm-hmm. And so when you thought about this and you was, you know, puzzling your brain, what were some of the challenges that you faced, you know, in actually putting it together?
Throughout the production of it?
Yes.
Well, I would say, you know, working as an independent filmmaker with very limited resources, thankfully a lot of my family and friends invested in the film.
It's always
thank you
good.
All so much for, you know, donating to this project. I'm so grateful. But you really do have to be creative when you're working with such limited resources. So thankfully my job actually lent me all the gear.
Wow.
Yes. And some of my coworkers who are industry professionals worked on the film for free. Just things like that. The way that it was all coming together, it just seemed like, you know, God really wanted this project to move forward. And I'm so grateful for it.
Well, I think it's because you probably helped a lot of people, too. When God see that you're helping someone else, he's always, you know, he's going to make sure his baby taken care of.
Yeah.
And to be able to have the equipment, you know, use this equipment for free and people work on yourself for free. Girl, that's favor.
Yes.
I didn't say favor totally and favor, but it sure feels good.
Yes, 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 for sure.
You know, and then too, a lot of times in this industry, people feel like if I'm not getting paid, then I don't want to be a part of it. And they don't realize the opportunities they miss.
Yeah, absolutely.
From just not helping, you know, if you help somebody else, oh my God, you able to just, doors open up for you.
Yeah, right.
You know, so tell us one of the things that you might have had a little, you know, challenge with of doing since it was, you know, you just starting to produce. So how did it feel for you?
The challenge is putting together the resources with the limited resources that you have access to. So, I mean, we had a certain budget, and that was amazing, but, you know, you want the world for this film. You really do. Yeah. And, I mean, $1 million wouldn't have been enough. It really wouldn't have been. So it's mainly, you know, it's again the puzzle pieces. It's trying to make the best film that you absolutely possibly can with the resources that you have. Mm-hmm. And that takes a lot of skill. It takes a lot of talent. It takes a lot of God's favor.
Yes.
And one of the things, too, since you guys are talking about, like, the budgeting, I think that this happened, in a sense, for a reason, only because when you do get a bigger budget film, you still won't just use it just because you know how to manage manager versus that's just, important. You know, no. just like, I got $50,000 to spend on just clothes. And you'd be like, yeah. wait a minute, we didn't even have no clothes, brother.
Yeah, yeah, yeah.
You know,
yeah.
so tell us a little bit, too, like when you was going into how important social media was for you, you know, in order to get things done.
Well, I think as we were doing the production of this film, I definitely had social media in mind, just from everything we were doing on set with behind-the-scenes photos, and because I knew that we would need all those kind of things when we were promoting the film at film festivals and things like that. So social media is very important. You get the word out about your film, but it also connects your audience to the project. Mm-hmm. And for me, everyone who donated to the film, I wanted them to be able to be brought along on the process mm-hmm. of it. Mm-hmm. So that's the part that social media is playing. We have a Facebook page. If you just go to Facebook and search in Fiorella short film, you'll find it. And if you could like us, like and follow us, that'd be great. So yeah, social media is very important.
So when you was actually, you know, doing the film and incorporating it and promoting it and different things like that, what did you say to yourself that this is happening? Like, how did you feel like, oh, my God, this is really happening for me? Like, what did you, how did that feel?
It felt amazing. And for me as a producer and kind of really working all of my contacts to be on this film and having access to this amazing cast, amazing crew, I really wanted to honor everyone. So that was a little bit of pressure that I was putting on myself. Like, I wanted this project to come out, to be completed, because a lot of short films don't get completed, unfortunately. Like, I've worked on so many projects and I've never seen them. Mm-hmm. So that was a huge fear for me, you know, going into Fiorella. So I was kind of really pushing people to make sure that we hit the deadlines and, you know, didn't have it go by the wayside in any way. So yeah, I just wanted to honor everyone's commitment to the project and to say thank you and have something that we can all be proud of.
So for you as an actress and you know, having a background of Liberia, tell us how, can you just like encourage someone else who is not originally from, you know, mm-hmm. LA, that's an actress, and feel like their culture, it can't be used, but you are a living example that, hey, I'm from Liberia, and it was a film exactly for me. So tell us a little bit about, you know, what they can do to just stay encouraged.
Well,
really.
To be encouraged, Liberia is a country that has struggled with war for so long, since like 1989, you know, and it's one of the poorest nations in the whole entire world. So for our stories to be told, that is, it's mind-boggling. So if you come from Trinidad and Tobago or Malaysia or wherever and you have stories to tell, tell it. Like, everyone's so, we've pretty much seen the whole American story, the white picket fence, you know, the whole traditional family thing. Mm-hmm. Everyone's now interested in what's going on and what are the lives like about an 8-year-old boy in Cambodia or a 13-year-old girl in Kenya. So tell your stories. The world wants to know, and there's so many people that can relate. So.
Yeah. Oh, yeah.
So can you tell us, too, like, give someone some unlimited opportunity that they're not just limited to one position, that they actually can, you know, do multiple things in the industry?
Oh, of course. I mean, I think as you go along, you figure out your talents, you know, and it's going to always grow. I mean, I meet so many people and they're like, oh, I'm writer, producer, director. And I like to add the joke, oh, or editor, gaffer, all that. And they're like, no, I'm like, just joking. It's okay. but yeah, you just figure out your skill sets. If you are bad at something, you find somebody that's good at it, you work with them, mm-hmm. you collaborate, you know, mm-hmm. you find people that are good. Mm-hmm. I mean, I can't do sound design, you know, so I have to find somebody to do that. Yeah. So yeah, you just find talented people, you surround yourself with talented people, and the more you do that, the better you'll do and the further you'll go. You can't do it yourself.
So tell us, you know, exactly where people can you know, stay in contact with you guys and make sure that, you know, that they watch the trailer and watch the short film.
Yeah.
And, you know, everything that they need to know, because we need to know, right? We need to know.
Okay. Well, to keep updated with us, you can definitely check out our Facebook page. If you like it and follow it, you know, everything that happens with the film will be going on there for sure. We also have a website. It's www.hectorlin.com/Fiorella, and everything is updated there as well. So you can watch our trailer, and you know, hopefully once we hear more about film festivals and things like that, you'll be updated.
Mm-hmm. For sure. Yeah, and also, you know, how they can, your Facebook page, what's your Facebook page?
Oh, I'm probably more active on Instagram. So.
Instagram, what's your Instagram?
Yeah, so Instagram, whatever. I am Raquel Davies.
And you have Instagram, Facebook?
I just joined Instagram because of her, this lovely girl. She just pushes me into everything. So my Instagram, I don't actually remember it, but...
What's your name?
Producer Danae.
Producer Danae.
I know it. Yeah.
And Danae Jones for Facebook, which I'm always on.
Well, you guys, I thank you so much for being on the show.
Thank you.
I appreciate it. And I want you all to make sure that you watch it. Stay up date with these ladies, because these ladies are like going all the way. Liberia is doing it up here.
Yes.
So anyways, I appreciate you. Keep living life unlimited. Until next time, your girl, Melody.
Again, the thing y'all wanna show up.
Oh, we wouldn't miss this.
Let's toast. Let's toast to a super fun night.
Yeah.
And where do you think you're going dressed like one boy? Jesus.